Over the last decade, we have achieved the fastest economic growth in the history of our country. Despite global headwinds, Indian industry has sustained growth because of the energy of our business community. The political stability and rational policy environment provided by our governments also made this possible. We believe that economic prosperity must include every single person. Poverty is neither befitting of human dignity, nor is it conducive to good business. I would like to state clearly, and I've said it earlier in a meeting, I would like to state clearly that poverty cannot be fought without growth. You absolutely 100% need growth to fight poverty. There is absolutely no confusion in my mind about this. India is a system, there is a business engine, and there are people. You have to empower the business engine, and you have to empower the people. It is a partnership. Maintaining robust growth has enabled the UPA government to invest in people. In 10 years, and this is a huge achievement which is not spoken about much, but in 10 years, almost a third of India's poor people have come out of poverty. They have risen above the poverty line. Now, there is a view that our investments in food security, employment guarantee, and rural development are a drag on economic growth. I don't believe that there is such a trade-off. I don't believe there is a trade-off between investments in the social sector and in economic growth. For me, it is today's investments in people that create tomorrow's markets. And it is today's markets that allow us to invest in our people's futures. A mindset revolution is the fuel for economic growth. Today, self-help groups have shattered the hold of moneylenders. They have enabled millions of women to seek credit to finance their aspirations. They are the new age customers for our banks. Women now believe that credit is their right, and they see it as an opportunity. Such mindset changes are the results of years of sustained political effort, years of investment in people, in their education, in their health, in rural infrastructure, and in job creation. The most important thing that we have to do is to create fulfilling and rewarding jobs for our youngsters. We have this huge energy, and we have to get them connected to the global market. Those who are poor, those who belong to the middle class, and those among the 700 million people who are above the poverty line but below the middle class threshold. These are the craftsmen who build this country. We need to connect them to the global markets. India must become the global leader in manufacturing. This has to be one of our core missions. Let's target growing the manufacturing sector to 25% of GDP, generating 100 million new jobs in the next decade. I sincerely believe that we can do this. We're a young country, we can do this. The dramatic improvement we need in productivity demands that we provide the right enabling environment. This will require the political will to take difficult decisions. Take difficult decisions on labor laws. All labor laws have forced businesses to use contract labor. As you know, they are often underpaid and unprotected. India needs a modern and flexible labor market where labor has a fair share and is protected by international labor standards. We must reform the power sector and ensure that businesses have reliable and affordable access to power. While absorbing the latest technologies from around the world, Indian manufacturing must also be built on Indian patents. We have to open up our manufacturing sector and foster competition. The industrial corridors, Delhi-Mumbai, Mumbai-Bengaluru, Bengaluru-Chennai, and Ludhiana-Kolkata, will revolutionize high value-added manufacturing and provide millions of jobs to our youngsters. Agriculture is an equally high priority. We are on the threshold of a second green revolution. Price realization and improved productivity have raised farm wages significantly in the last decade. We have made greater investments in critical areas such as micronutrients, micro-irrigation, satellite weather forecasting, and access to affordable credit to farmers. We're sitting on the threshold. Our efforts to raise productivity and farm income will continue unabated. High inflation on the back of high food prices is an immediate concern. It has stretched household budgets and constrained industrial growth, and it hurts our people. And it hurts them every single day. Beating inflation is our top priority. We must crack down on hoarding and profiteering. We must ease infrastructure bottlenecks and rapidly modernize the supply chain from field to plate. Now, a little bit about politics. Around the time Mahatma Gandhi was making his address to Fiki in 1931, the dark shadows of fascism had begun to spread over Europe. A party built on a divisive ideology full of hatred, arrogance, and misguided notions of superiority plunged the world into a war that brought Germany to its knees. Millions of people were killed and communities impoverished. Businesses were destroyed. What our people understood intuitively, but the Europeans of 1930 did not, was that wealth cannot be constructed on poverty. Peace cannot be constructed on hatred. And societies cannot be built on injustice. And this is something fundamental that we in the Congress Party understand. India's democracy has never ever been more vibrant. What will India look like when she celebrates her 100th birthday? Our vision for India is of a country whose economy would be the largest in the world, second to nobody. Our vision is also of an India which would have deepened its democracy to the grassroots, a democracy where every citizen would have voice in government, where power would have been devolved to the lowest levels, to elected bodies. An India where every political party would be truly representative and truly democratic. But above all, our vision is of an India united by compassion, not power. An India living in harmony, not in hatred. Thriving in peace, rather than suffocating in conflict. Filled with humility, not with hubris. Where poverty has been confined to the dustbin of history. An India where government serves the people, rather than people serve the government. The central mission of the Congress was defined by Gandhiji as the industrial progress and prosperity of India. The Congress mission is anchored in a very simple idea. It is not a new idea. It is an ancient Indian idea. An idea where humanity is united in love, in compassion, and harmony. And in this great, great country of ours, it has always and always will trump hatred. Thank you.